The Omaha Supernovas are back in action this Tuesday, April 2nd, versus the San Diego Mojo at the Viejas Arena in San Diego. The Mullen Motors pregame show with Derek Pearson and Renee Saunders starts at 8 p.m. with first serve at 9. Make sure to tune in to the next Ag Appraisal and Realty postgame show right after the match ends. Catch all the action on your flagship station, 93.7 The Ticket, and statewide on the Supernovas radio network.
My dream was to work in commercial banking, but it required a college degree and I didn't have one. I found out that Doane had classes for adult learners on the Lincoln campus and online. So I earned my bachelor's degree and 5 months later, I landed my dream job. I decided to continue my education and now I'm working on my MBA at Doane. For me, the Doane experience has been life-changing.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox KFXL Weather, sponsored by John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning.
Your Lincoln forecast for today, some clouds this morning will give way to sunshine this afternoon. It'll be breezy, snapping high around 55. Tonight, mainly clear and breezy, and overnight low around 33. And tomorrow, we'll see mainly sunny skies and more wind. An afternoon high around 54. Meteorologist Kyle Klecker for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
This is 93.7 The Ticket.
Look at me short. Look at me short. I'm the captain now.
Three-time national champion, Vershawn Jackson.
Touchdown. Vershawn Jackson, number 34, gets the touchdown.
Terrell Farley. Defending Terrell Farley,
who last week in his first start was a holy terror. Number 43.
And Jake Bakoven.
I've talked a few cats. They said that Bak got some game, man.
Coming at you live from the Koppel Chevrolet GMC studios in the heart of Lincoln, America. On air and online at theticketfm.com. Powered by Bauer. Here he is, Vershawn Jackson.
Hold on.
Take that off now. I'm getting hot. I'm tired. That was about a minute, wasn't it? Good workout. Bak, you got to shut me down sometime. You can't let me just keep going.
Oh, I thought it was pretty energetic. I thought it was good.
I got to apologize to some people. Okay? I'm going to start the show off with an apology. I want to apologize to everybody that listens to us. We haven't talked about the women's Final Four at all. And we need to talk about it. Cue it up, Bak. Cue up the women's Final Four.
Well, yeah, I mean, yesterday was one of the best days probably in women's college basketball history. Iowa and LSU, a rematch of the championship game. Of course, there was a lot of you can't see me type of imagery from the last one. We didn't get to that with this one. There was still plenty of controversy around the post game and the pregame, as there always is with LSU. But Iowa ultimately gets the win, 94-87, with Caitlin Clark going off with 9 threes, over 40 points again, and likely an end of the career. We'll see with Angel Reese, but a lot of star power. And on the other side, you had UConn again advancing to the Final Four. If you stayed up late for that, so it was a. It was a big day, but I mean, the majority of the attention, of course, was on LSU and Iowa.
So games are set in the women's bracket.
Games are set.
Who's playing? Who's playing who?
Kentucky and Iowa. And
who you like?
I think Geno finds a way to slow her down. I mean, it's impossible to slow this Caitlin Clark down. She got mad range. I seen her yesterday, last night. And she killed. I mean, LSU, you could tell me LSU played a good game.
I did.
I seen it when they was up by 8. Yes. So it kind of scared me that I was probably going to get knocked out, which I didn't care because I'm not an Iowa fan.
Right.
But you got to cheer for Caitlin Clark, how she shoots that ball, because now if you watch her on TV and you haven't seen her play before, now you see why she's probably the best shooter in college football history.
By far.
I mean, college basketball. But the way she shoots that rock and passes it and just an all-around team player, Iowa had a good run. They got a good run, but beating UConn is going to be a hard one. And then trying to beat South Carolina is probably going to be a harder one.
Well, wait. So, hold on. Iowa plays who then?
They UConn. Play UConn, yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And South Carolina plays who?
Arkansas.
No, North Carolina State.
Yeah.
As well as the men's Final Four, they made the women's.
All right. Who do we like? Who do you like blocking that first game?
Well, for clarity, it is 1-seed Iowa against 3-seed UConn and 1-seed South Carolina undefeated against 3-seed North Carolina State. So the favorites would be Iowa and South Carolina. And I'm not going to go past that. I think similar to the men's game, where if you had Purdue match up with UConn, that's the heavyweights that everybody wanted to see. I think a similar situation, if you have Iowa take on South Carolina, I mean, we talked about last night being
a big day for women's basketball. So you telling me UConn is not a threat to Iowa?
UConn is. I mean, UConn's a historically great program. Hasn't been what they used to be in the last couple of years. I'm not saying it can't happen. I mean, Nebraska beat Iowa. So, I mean, it can happen on any given day, as we know, an upset in sports. But I want to see Iowa and South Carolina.
Yeah, I'm with you on that, Bach. I think those are the top two teams in the country. You got the top team versus the top player.
Right. And
I think it offers for – you know how many people are going to watch that game?
Oh, yeah. That's record-breaking.
That would be a record-breaking game for women's sports for those two teams. I don't know if you – do you watch UConn and NC State? Not really.
No, not as much.
Not really.
Not going to get the same – draw the same eyeballs.
If Caitlin's in it, you're going to – it doesn't matter who's the opponent, right? But it's what, first of all, NC State's about to get smashed. South Carolina, them girls ain't, listen.
5 new starters.
Who won the championship last year in the girls?
It was LSU. That's why the Iowa-LSU rematch was so big.
Perfect. Before that?
South Carolina.
Before that?
South Carolina. Well, did they go back-to-back, Bob?
I think they may have. I'll look it up.
So, My point is, and when they got knocked off last year, it was a big ta-da, right? Because they were undefeated or something. I don't know what it was, but
they lost to Iowa.
Well, there you go. Yeah. Okay, so there's writing in the wall right there, Terrell.
But it's a whole new team, though.
Nah. It's Iowa versus South Carolina.
So South Carolina won in 2022, but not 2021. They did win in 2017, and they've been to the Final Four four straight years
now. Yeah, there you go. My point is, South Carolina's a threat to be reckoned with, right?
Oh, yeah.
So I like. I want to see. I'm rolling with Caitlin. It's right next door. I can literally step over in Iowa. I can walk and step over in Iowa and be in Nebraska.
Yeah. People are already upset. Eric says first Rashawn is a Jayster. Now Terrell loves the Hawkeyes. What is happening?
No. I'm with South Carolina. I'm with South Carolina.
Oh, you going to South Carolina
all the way?
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, I can. Listen.
I mean, I said
I can go for the enemy sometimes.
But why can't I compliment a player? That's what I'm doing.
Yeah,
I'm
not saying.
Yeah, I'm not. But at the same time, respect is due, Bobby. Yeah, you got to respect her game. I mean, that can say like, hey, I don't like. Who? Let's say somebody we play against. Who?
Chad May.
Yeah, I don't like him, but hey, he's a good person.
Mm-hmm. Hey, person, man. Listen, man. You can't try to. There hasn't been a Caitlin Clark in so long. Name another Caitlin Clark. Now, it's all been dominated for the most part. There's Taurasi and some of these other little ones. But they didn't have the skill set that she has.
Well, when you say that, I mean, there hasn't been a Caitlin Clark. Nobody else has scored as many points in NCAA history. Right. So there hasn't been another Caitlin Clark.
Man, I've never seen a girl with a step back as wicked as hers. I mean, she – step back. Ah, dime. Come on, man. Remember I told y'all I would have doubled and tripled and quadrupled her. She wouldn't beat me down the stretch. Remember when she beat us?
Mm-hmm.
So it's I like Caitlin because you know what? I'm a bandwagoner. And those are the teams that's playing. And I think they're the favorites to win.
No, I'm a Southern guy. I'm going to stick with South Carolina. I got to go with the South.
I'm going to go with the Midwest.
Well, it's interesting because I know Jay Williams, I believe it was Jay Williams a couple weeks ago, said she can't be the GOAT if she doesn't win a championship.
You can't.
You don't think so?
Nope. You can't.
Say that again.
I mean, you could be the best player, but you got to win. If you want to be the GOAT of this thing, you got to win a national title.
She can't be the GOAT if she doesn't win a national title.
I think that is correct.
So then who would be the GOAT? Who's the best women's basketball
You don't
player?
Want that hanging over your head. It's like Dan Marino or somebody.
Who's the best women's
It's like
basketball
Dan Marino.
Player.
Played all those years and supposed to be a great Hall of Fame quarterback. Didn't never win nothing.
And you know what? The kids of the day don't even know who Dan Marino
is. Because you know why? He didn't win anything. I mean, not saying it's a bad thing, but hey,
you won. They went undefeated.
What, not him.
No,
Larry,
not him.
That's Larry Zonka, man. What are you talking about?
Wait. You didn't let me finish. There was a year that the Dolphins were undefeated during the season.
It wasn't Dan Marino. I tell
you.
Yeah,
it was. Okay. One of them years.
That was like the early 70s.
Yeah, no, but right. I thought one of those years.
It's about Dan Fouts.
Maybe I am talking about Dan Fouts. I thought one of those years, though, Dan Marino and him was like 15-1 or something, and then they lost the first playoff game. I'm going to ask Siri when I get my phone. Mine ain't called Siri no more. His name is Sam.
Sam?
Yeah.
His best regular season record, Marino's, was 14-2 in 1984.
Oh, dang.
That's when he was the MVP. So that might be kind of what you're thinking there.
Nah, it must have been back in the day, like you were saying.
Yeah.
They were
so it's just like this. Would Tommy be the GOAT without them two championships?
No.
Okay, so would...
You would have to...
Johnny Rogers be one of the GOATs without that Heisman?
No.
Would Mike Rozier be one of the GOATs without that Heisman?
No.
Okay, would Eric Crouch be one of those guys without the Heisman?
No.
Okay, so you got to... Like, Tommy won it. That doesn't mean Tommy's the best GOAT ever at Nebraska. He's one of the top.
Well, is he?
I think he's probably the most recognized Husker.
Recognizable. I mean, when you think about an All-American, somebody that went All-American to the team, as somebody, if you take him off the team, it affects the team. So when you look at quarterbacks, and we had this discussion, but Tommy Frazier's got to be in the last 25 years.
One of the best quarterbacks ever in college football.
He didn't play the last 25 years, but yeah.
30.
You're getting older.
My bad. Holy smokes. Are you serious?
No, he didn't play the last 25 years.
25 years ago would have been what?
99?
It's 29.
Oh, my God. Wait, how many years? I'm having an old man moment. Hold on. So, 94, how many years ago?
It's about to be
30.
That'd
be 30 years.
30
ago,
years.
Yeah.
Just this year.
Yeah.
30?
They having a 30-year
Three
reunion?
Decades.
I don't know, but if not, we are. 30?
We're 30 next year. Y'all about what, 27?
Well, 28? I mean, I think I was there in 94.
Yeah.
30?
That is ancient history. Put them over there with King Tuck and put your football up, your cleats. When you blow them cleats off, you got... Ain't they dusty?
For comparison's sake, in 1994, when you were on campus, that'd be somebody like somebody talking about 1964.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I'm having a moment, guys. I'm having a meltdown moment.
You remember that time?
30 years?
Do you remember that movie, Back to the Future, when Marty went back to the old time and they had them old dresses and they had their hair slicked back?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that's hard to fathom that it's been 30 years, man.
Yeah, they say we play barefooted.
So, yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. See, 30 years.
Leather helmets back then?
No chin straps. We had to hold our face masks while we was running.
So 97 would be how many? 33?
Oh, that would be less. 27 then.
Yeah. 95 is,
I told you I'm having a moment.
Years.
I told you I'm having a moment.
Okay.
Things that are supposed to be going down are going up.
Listen here, sir.
You guys got me wrinkled. 94. You got me frizzle frazzled. 30 years ago, are you kidding me right now? No wonder why they'd be like, you guys are living in the past. Now I know why they say that.
Yep. Yeah. It's the 90s were a while ago.
Oh
now.
My God.
Yeah, your beard. Hey,
give me some.
Your beard is crystal white. You are.
Bad.
Oh, look, 30 years ago, and look at your beard. What you talking about?
Should I put Just For Men in it?
Yeah.
No, I'm not going to do it. I gotta, come on, man. I like this old man look. It's, it don't look bad.
Women like salt and pepper, don't
they?
Well,
I don't know, do they?
You ask your, yeah, I don't know.
I'm saying, some of them do, some of them don't. Right, a lot of them don't. They'd be like, yeah, hey, you're too old.
Yeah.
He's, look how old he is. Look at his beard.
See, that's why I cut off everything except my mustache.
Who are you fooling? I'm not trying to look good for nobody. You guess what I need to do?
What?
Come to the radio station. You know what I do when I leave?
What?
Go sell some cars. You know what I do when Saturdays come and it's game day?
You go to the
games. I go to the games. You know what I do after the games? Talk back on the radio again. So it's, my life is simple. And I take care of my grandkids. Simple. Nothing too hard, nothing too complicated, man. I don't need to be. I'm a grandpa. I'm supposed to look the part, right? I got five grandkids. Am I supposed to look the part or not?
Hey,
now, what's that going to look like? Let me tell you what happens when I cut this off. I get my grandkids. I got 10. All right. She's going to be 10 this month. But 9, 6, 5, 1, 6 months. I got my grandkids. I got all this cut. What are they going to say to me?
Young grandpa.
No. How old are your kids? How old are your children?
Still got gray in it. I mean,
I said if I cut it off like yours and just had this, if we ain't no gray, it won't be no gray.
Yeah.
Just be a couple little strings. Yeah, a couple little
stragglers.
You wouldn't be able to tell. I look at that young. If I cut this off, I'll cut like 20 years off.
Nah, you still be in your 40s, 10? But your early 40s.
I'll take that. I'm at the late 40s. If you tell me I'm still in 40s, bro, I'll take that.
You look real old now.
I'll take that.
You look 50.
I did look at a picture of me 9 years ago. And let me just say this. I didn't have nowhere near the gray that I got right now. So I don't know what's been going on.
You don't get stressed out in the head.
I didn't have this much gray 3 years ago when we started the radio station.
I don't think so.
Okay. So you is one of the reasons why I got this. You can say what you want. But me and I know what's going on. 93.7 The Ticket Style.
We'll be right back.
Thank you.
If the week's been too hectic to even think about dinner, or your family can't handle one more night of leftovers, then it's time to let Hog Wild do the cooking. Hog Wild's family packs are one heck of a good deal for a complete barbecue meal loaded with all the smoked meats, tasty sides, buns, and sauces you need to feed your family. Order online at GoHogWild.com. Hog Wild Pit Barbecue, 3210 Cornhusker Highway in Lincoln.
But don't be late, we close at 8.
Okay, it's time to sell the house. How do we even begin to choose from the hundreds of realtors in town?
Easy, we make a pros list.
You mean a pros and cons list?
No, just a pros list. We need someone with pro photography to showcase the house in the best possible way, pro marketing to make sure we get maximum exposure, pro negotiations so we know we get the best price.
This is one of those times where you already know the right answer, isn't it?
You know it is. Ben Bleicher and Professional Realty Group.
Contact Ben Bleicher and the team at Professional Realty Group of Berkshire Hathaway's Home Services Ambassador. Online at prg-ne.com.
At Union Bank, people don't have your money. Your money has people. First Home people, investment people, people who answer the phone and your chats, dream car people, dream retirement people, driving your dream car in your dream retirement people, small business people, credit card people, and all the other people you need. At Union Bank, our people help you do more than you dreamed possible. So stop in and say hello. We can't wait to see you. Union Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
Are you looking to get into the electrical construction industry or wanting a new scene? The electrical workers of Local Union 265 are now hiring licensed journeymen and apprentices and are offering great pay and benefits. Call Mike at 402-875-1034 to apply. Start your electrical career today.
Hey guys, it's Bill Bush. Next Ag Appraisal and Realty has opened a new location in Pender, Nebraska, in addition to their office in Lincoln. The real estate world can be confusing, so why wouldn't you want an expert helping you every step of the way? If you're looking to buy or sell farmland in Nebraska, Kansas, or Iowa, give Ethan Sorensen a call today at 402-380-0432 or visit them online at nextagrealestate.com. Next Ag Appraisal and Realty with locations in Lincoln and now Pender, Nebraska.
Rico here with HIS Auto Care at 70th and Van Dorn, letting you know HIS is a great place to bring your vehicle for service. With superior service, bumper to bumper, we'll treat your vehicle like it's your mother's. Doesn't get any better than that. So call 402 888-498-8934, and HIS Auto will make you glad you did. 5% off, mention this ad, and for sure your mother will be proud you called. 402-488-8934, HIS Auto Care, 7th and Van Doren. God bless you.
Hi, folks. Sean Callahan here for Koppel Chevrolet GMC, and the Chevrolet and GMC Truck Month is now underway. We've got huge savings in Louisville. Get $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months on select models. Yes, you heard right. That's $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months happening right now at Koppel. So take that short money-saving drive down 144th Street or check us out online at koppelcars.com. You'll be glad you did. All deals with approved credit. Stock number G214773.
Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits is now open in Lincoln. Shop our expansive collection of wine, beer, spirits, and cigars at 5040 North 27th Street. From top-shelf liquor to crowd-favorite beer, Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits has a beverage for every taste and every budget. Plus, join our loyalty program to earn rewards and save on future purchases. Shop Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits at 5040 North 27th Street in Lincoln. That's 5040 North 27th Street.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox KFXL Weather, sponsored by John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning.
Your Lincoln forecast for today, some clouds this morning will give way to sunshine this afternoon. It'll be breezy, an afternoon high around 55. Tonight, mainly clear and breezy, an overnight low around 33. And tomorrow, we'll see mainly sunny skies and more wind, with an afternoon high around 54. Meteorologist Kyle Klecker for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
For over 15 years, Integrated Life Choices has empowered individuals with disabilities in Lincoln and throughout Nebraska. They provide comprehensive services from group homes and independent living services to job training, ensuring fulfilling lives for those that they serve. Now, they're inviting you to join their mission. If you're passionate about making a difference in the lives of people with developmental disabilities, explore rewarding career opportunities with them. Learn more about their services and apply today at www.ilc.net. Be a part of Integrated Life Choices, where your work truly changes lives.
The best time to have your air conditioner serviced is before you really need it. Call Bryant now and schedule your spring air conditioning service check. No matter what brand equipment you have, Bryant's trained technicians will thoroughly clean, inspect, and test to make sure it's ready to cool efficiently when hot weather hits. You'll stay cool and comfortable when you need it most. Just call 467-1111 to schedule your air conditioning check. Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing. We do whatever it takes.
Drinking and driving causes serious harm to friends, family members, and loved ones. In 2021, 65 people were killed in Nebraska by a car crash involving a drunk driver. Do not drink and drive. By drinking less, you can still be here for your loved ones. If you or a loved one is looking for help, find a treatment facility near you at findtreatment.gov. For immediate support, call, text, or chat 988.
Brought to you by Nebraska DHHS in partnership with SAMHSA.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
We back. I can't wait, man. Spring game. The countdown is on. Today's the second.
You get excited for spring
25.
Game? I just go see.
Yeah, I get excited for spring game.
Spring game for us.
Crazy.
Spring game for us is
this
like.
This year I am.
It's like a family reunion. You know what I'm saying? You get to see everybody you know that you have been seeing throughout the years that traditionally that comes to the spring game. So it's more like a family reunion to me. Just sit on the sidelines, chit chat, probably leave early, go across the street to the Blur. Blur, shout out to Blur. They're on their way back. So, you know, we do our parties there and can't wait to see those guys too.
When you actually seeing some real football going on, you ain't going to go nowhere. You're going to be glued to the tube. Remember that.
When I think usually.
When the last time you sat through a whole spring game?
I've never.
Thank you.
I didn't say sit through, but this
he
year.
He didn't say a whole
this,
spring
year. Listen to me.
It's part of the spring year.
This year I am. You know why?
And I bet
because
you,
when hey, you look. Get away, when you leave, you don't get a chance to see those younger guys do their thing. And I want to see the future. So if you leave early, you don't get a chance to see the future.
I left the spring game right before the Jack Hoffman moment
See?
Yeah. Sometimes you'll, one of the most special moments of the year or in Nebraska football history. And I just said, that's no spring game for me.
Now, here's why I want to go back and say, I wish we had old tape of the last nine games that VJ has been to, because I bet you if they recorded those games, VJ back will be towards the back of the players looking at them, and he's engaging in conversation the whole game.
Oh,
and,
the spring game, huh?
It's every spring game.
Yeah, every spring.
He takes a, he takes a million pictures, because I got a picture of all of us at the spring game on my Facebook. That's one of my cover pictures of about eight of us. And guess who's in the picture?
Who?
Rashawn Jackson. Oh, jeez. Cam Britt Taylor. Who else?
You asked me to be in the picture. So
we all take pictures like that all the time. Don't do that.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, you're a pitcher guy.
Yeah, but I'm going to watch the game this year. I want to watch. The reason why I haven't been watching the game, because it don't look like no game.
Spring ball.
Listen, I played in spring ball. I know it was a long time ago. I know that.
Yeah, 30 years ago, Zach.
So what? It was still spring, and it was still ball.
Yeah, it was snowing then. Then your spring game.
No, it wasn't.
Have it ever snowed in one of your spring games in the 4 years, 5 years you were here?
No, never. No, don't reach again. Reach again.
I'm not reaching.
You are reaching. Talking about snow in April? In April.
It has snowed in April.
I didn't say it's never snowed.
Right before a spring game, it snowed.
Five consecutive years, it never snowed during spring.
Before, the day before it has.
During your tenure?
Yeah. I could tell you where we was at.
It was short. What year would that have been? 94, 95, or 96? No,
this was like 2000.
Are you kidding me right now?
2018, 19.
Are we listening to this?
We was in Omaha at the Steve Warren thing.
Oh,
and
you talking about
that
hey, man, they tinkering with the weather now. You can't say that.
Oh, my God.
You can't say that now. Try to go and be. Yeah, that's what I said. You was reaching. You went to 18. How you going to go talk about me being 30 years the last time I played spring ball or 25?
It just snowed about 2 weeks ago. A little bit.
The game is April 27th.
Yeah. It never snowed in Nebraska in April 27th.
I'm quite sure it has, Terrell. I said for the spring game.
Okay.
It hasn't snowed the spring game.
So I'm taking you off.
Can you take my words literally?
So I'm taking you off, Hannah.
Yeah,
don't talk. Don't
I just thought, no, Terrell, no. So the reason why I took my shirt off and I got my extra medium shirt on, this is, my undershirt, because Terrell going to come in here talking about, yeah, you looking like you 205. I said, well, what that mean? I thought he was giving me a compliment, but when you've been a big guy and they tried to peg you as a bully, everybody now wants to try to take a shot because they think I'm smaller, right? And so I always say this. I had to, pin him up in here just to let him know. And he was like, oh, okay, VJ, you still there. Is you just a little bit smaller version of him? Yeah, it ain't going nowhere. You don't want none of this to knock a ball home? I told you, I'm faster than you now.
Yeah, that's a lie.
I'm faster than you.
That's
matter of fact,
lie.
During the break, we're going to run past here. We're going to run the 10, me against you.
Not in them Adidas, you ain't.
And these Adidas.
Yeah, them Adidas are not running shoes, VJ.
Bruh, these is called trainers.
Okay.
These is government issue.
All right.
Boy, watch it. I've been having them for like 10 years.
Hey, yeah. You start at the end of the block, and then I'll turn the camera on.
Nah.
I'll start wherever
are you
want,
running? Are you going? Are you racing?
No, I'm just saying the end of the race is in front of the window, so everybody can see who wins.
No,
and there's
ain't no way
argument.
In hell he going to beat me in running on a cold day, Bob.
Hey, let me tell you
this
something.
This is not going to – I mean, not even –
let me tell you something.
He wanted to do it for 10 yards one time.
Let me tell you something. And listen, I got out on him, and he did come back and catch me.
So yeah.
But that was at 245, 50 pounds.
No, that was
I'm 220 now.
No, that was like 200.
Bring it.
You was 230 then.
No, I was not.
Okay.
No, I was not.
All right.
No, we're gonna do it right out here.
Just because you get smaller, that don't mean you get faster.
Yeah, you're losing weight, so you should be able to carry
your
weight that you have a lot better when you lose weight. That's the point of losing weight.
Then you gotta retool yourself then.
I ain't hit the weight room yet.
Yeah, you gotta retool yourself.
I'm just still doing push-ups.
You gotta learn how to run with form when you
form,
lose weight.
You ain't gotta retool nothing.
Yeah, whatever, old
watch
man.
This. Watch this.
You'll never beat me, running.
I hear you.
We could be in a wheelchair.
I hear you.
We have a
wheelchair. I hope they're having them same type of wars that me and you having right now out there on the football field, Memorial
State.
When
we get 80 and we still doing the show, we can race in wheelchairs.
No, I know you can't beat me in that.
Yeah. They cut both of my legs off, and I still beat you in running. Oh, man.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, you're reaching.
Mr. Fast Guy.
You're reaching.
You ain't that fast.
We old now, remember?
Yeah, nah, okay.
You know you got a lot. I ain't going to say that. I'm going to be quiet about that.
Yeah, you're not going to beat me in running.
All right. I ain't going to talk no more. Done talking.
Yeah.
That's the box. That's how, when you know it's game time, Bob, for me, guess what I do?
Stop talking.
It's over with.
That's better 1,000 push-ups.
It's over with.
That's better 1,000 push-ups.
Nothing. I'm just going to go do it on the strength, on the muscle. Ain't that what they say? Is that the lingo? Do it on the strength, on the muscle?
You're asking the wrong guy.
Well, I'm just saying. He know what it is. Go out here and blow his doors off.
TTG, Bob. I'm trained to go. So that's never scared. Like bone crusher.
You could tell he listened to rap.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, the mic saying different lingo. People's lyrics and
I'm
stuff.
I'm going to make a rap up for you when I beat you in running.
The club and you think I'm a punk. I'm a roller. Well, come on, man. You know what I mean? Come on, man. That rap stuff is over with.
Hey, look.
Pup Daddy got popped up. It's over, bruh.
Hey, look.
It's over with.
Rapping and running ain't got nothing to do with what you're talking about.
All right, cool. Well, we just, you know, I got my banana. I got a nanner for some little fuel. We'll do it next. We'll do it at the top of the hour.
Is that coffee going to help?
That way I can warm up. Yeah, I'm.
Yeah.
Rah, rah.
So you really,
the motor, yeah. It's just kind of going.
But,
you know what I'm saying? But anybody that know cars, when they go back to them G-bodies and they go back to them 69 Chevelles and Corvettes and you hear. You know, you better beware. You don't believe it, huh?
Is that thing can go?
When it's sitting that idle, it just. Yeah, when you, listen, pull up on the car, and if you hear that, try to go fast. Watch what happens.
If my car's doing that, I got to go to the show.
No, but yours ain't doing that.
Seriously, I got one question. I got one question for you. Seriously, man. You're not going to beat me with no cargo pants on. I tell you that. That'll never happen. So you will never beat me with some cargo pants.
Like I said before.
And a belt. You will never race me in a belt.
Like I said.
Okay.
Like I said before, big mouth for knockerball.
Yeah, you better have some change of clothes.
You know what this is.
You better have change of clothes. What? You talk about running.
I might have my tights on under here.
Man, okay.
Talking about.
Nah, you like
keep it a buck.
Yeah, okay.
Keep it a buck.
Money G in Kansas says, I see some pulled hamstrings in the near future.
Pow, pow, pow. No.
Don't remind me of last year.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. Yeah, don't you wish that on me.
Yeah, you remember, I was going to say, you remember the last time you called yourself running, but we only running like this is can't be more than 5 yards. It's only five. We just going to do from here to the tree. That's it. Or you want to go for, because I don't want to embarrass you.
We'll go 20 yards.
We'll go 10.
Nah.
Compromise.
No, this is not who gets the best start and win. This is, you got to give somebody a chance. So 20 yards.
I'm going to put my shirt back on because, you know, I just wanted to make sure you knew VJ still, you know. I don't know why everybody think that, but, you know, it's all good. It's all good. We about to test this metal right now. You ready?
Nah.
What you talking about?
Yeah,
don't go popping off and then all of a sudden act like you don't know what I'm talking about.
Cargo pants on O Street.
Yeah. And if you lose,
that'll never happen.
You got some explaining to do.
Not with them.
This window's in the finish line. I'll put it on the screen during the break. You can see who wins.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Listen, 93.7 a ticket. We're powered
by
Bauer.
Infrastructure.
Bauer.
Underground
branch
excavator.
That's what I'm saying.
What you got on? You might wear some church shoes on. What you got on?
Church shoes on. We'll be right back.
The Omaha Supernovas are back in action this Tuesday, April 2nd, versus the San Diego Mojo at the Viejas Arena in San Diego. The Mullen Motors pregame show with Derek Pearson and Renee Saunders starts at 8 p.m. with first serve at 9. Make sure to tune in to the next Ag Appraisal and Realty postgame show right after the match ends. Catch all the action on your flagship station, 93.7 The Ticket, and statewide on the Supernovas Radio Network.
Sick of being upsold at gyms?
My guy, you're currently a base member. For $90 more, I can upgrade you to our Shred membership. For $130 more, you'll be a Swole member. And for just $300 more, you'll reach Sweat Platinum.
At Planet Fitness, you'll get energy without the upsell. Never pushy, always free fitness training and equipment for every workout. It's fitness that fits your budget. Join Planet Fitness for just $1 down and $10 a month. Cancel anytime. Deal ends Friday, April 12th. See Home Club for details.
Okay, it's time to sell the house. How do we even begin to choose from the hundreds of realtors in town?
Easy. We make a pros list.
You mean a pros and cons list?
No, just a pros list. We need someone with pro photography to showcase the house in the best possible way, pro marketing to make sure we get maximum exposure, pro negotiations so we know we get the best price.
This is one of those times where you already know the right answer, isn't it?
You know it is. Ben Bleicher and Professional Realty Group.
Contact Ben Bleicher and the team at Professional Realty Group of Berkshire Hathaway's Home Services Ambassador. Online at prg-ne.com.
At Parkview Animal Hospital in Lincoln, it's not just the professional care that sets them apart, but their warm staff and state-of-the-art facilities. Whether it's for a routine checkup or a comprehensive medical procedure, at Parkview, your pet isn't just another number, but a valued member of their caring family. Visit them at pahlincoln.com today and in person just south of 14th and Pine Lake Road. Parkview Animal Hospital, your pet, our passion. For happier, healthier furry friends.
Drinking and driving causes serious harm to friends, family members, and loved ones. In 2021, 65 people were killed in Nebraska by a car crash involving a drunk driver. Do not drink and drive. By drinking less, you can still be here for your loved ones. If you or a loved one is looking for help, find a treatment facility near you at findtreatment.gov. For immediate support, call, text, or chat 988.
Brought to you by Nebraska DHHS in partnership with SAMHSA.
Tanner's Bar and Grill is the perfect place to watch the NCAA tournament from the round of 64 all the way to the championship. Bring your friends and family in to enjoy Tanner's delicious hamburgers, chicken lips, and daily specials, and wash it down with one of their tons of options of beers. You'll never have an issue finding the game, as there are TVs everywhere throughout the space. So get in early, grab your spot, and settle in for a day of NCAA tournament basketball at Tanner's Bar and Grill, 30th and Yankee Hill.
Hi everyone, Kendall Warnock, A1 Automotive in downtown Lincoln. Spring is here, summer is fast approaching. With weddings, vacations, and weekend getaways on your mind, do not let car issues prevent you from getting where you need to be. Car problems shouldn't be something. Let us get you back on the road. Diagnose all makes and models from Porsches to Hondas, Toyotas, and Chevrolets. We fix a variety of issues with all of them with our talented techs and our experienced staff. A1 Automotive, 11th and L, downtown Lincoln, always.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox, KFXL Weather. Brought to you by Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing.
Your Lincoln forecast for today, some clouds this morning will give way to sunshine this afternoon. It'll be breezy, an afternoon high around 55. Tonight, mainly clear and breezy, an overnight low around 33. And tomorrow, we'll see mainly sunny skies and more wind, an afternoon high around 54. I'm meteorologist Kyle Klecker for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Hey guys, it's Bill Bush. Next Ag Appraisal and Realty has opened a new location in Pender, Nebraska, in addition to their office in Lincoln. The real estate world can be confusing, so why wouldn't you want an expert helping you every step of the way? If you're looking to buy or sell farmland in Nebraska, Kansas, or Iowa, give Ethan Sorensen a call today at 402-380-0432 or visit them online at nextagrealestate.com. Next Ag Appraisal and Realty with locations in Lincoln and now Pender, Nebraska.
The best time to have your air conditioner serviced is before you really need it. Call Bryant now and schedule your spring air conditioning service check. No matter what brand equipment you have, Bryant's trained technicians will thoroughly clean, inspect, and test to make sure it's ready to cool efficiently when hot weather hits. You'll stay cool and comfortable when you need it most. Just call 467-1111 to schedule your air conditioning check. Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing. We do whatever it takes.
On the Block with Strick and Austin.
I think about all the infrastructure that got built up behind the scenes by Coach Osborne, that Coach Solich took over. And then some of that infrastructure was eroded. Matt Rhule still has to prove this, but I think Matt Rhule's style is that, yeah, he'd like the infrastructure in place, but I think Matt Rhule has the personality to do everything in his power to bend it to the way he wants it.
Weekdays from 2 to 4 on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com. Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Do my Curtis Blow thing. Yeah, welcome back to The Ticket 93.7. All righty. Guess what, y'all? Warren Sapp joins Colorado coaching staff and is going to be serving as a graduate assistant. So he went to school, VJ. Well, you can call it a school, but he graduated.
So online?
He's a GA assistant. So he went to, what's the name of that school was?
Kaplan?
No.
Grand Canyon University?
Texas Seminary Christian University.
Seminary? He's a pastor?
Yeah, I guess he is.
What?
I guess. I don't know, but whatever it
is. What did he get a degree in?
It didn't say.
Oh.
It didn't say, but he's going to be a grad assistant, and that's something we're going to have to watch out on the sidelines this year when we play, you know, because he's a good studier of the game and he'll be able to help them boys out. You know, I just want to give you a quick something. And Deion's got former coaches that coach the NFL on his team. Pat Shurmur, who's the offensive coordinator now. He has Warren Sapp. He has the one of the defensive guys is a former NFL guy. But, you know, good thing for Warren Sapp getting in coaching now.
Well, I think it's an honor for Deion to have that much respect for him and know that he needs him to bring him back as a graduate assistant. I mean, Warren Sapp, if I'm 49, Warren Sapp got to be 51.
He's 51.
Yeah. Yeah, but the thing about it is, you know, you can't be an analysis because you can't talk to the kids. So he had to be a grad assistant to actually coach individually.
That's what I would want to
so
do.
So an analyst can't even speak to the kids. You know what I'm saying?
But what do you mean?
I mean, they can't coach him.
What is Coach Brown?
Whatever it is, he can't coach him.
Where's Coach Brown?
I don't know what Coach Brown is.
Okay.
So why it says that, why it's considered an entry-level position on most staff, grad assistants are allowed to directly coach players on the field while analysts are not.
Mm, gotcha.
So, you know, that's
the thing. So they kind of just be facilitators.
Yeah.
They can't say, hey, come here. Okay.
Coach Brown's the director of player support and outreach.
There you go.
A lot of different titles here.
Yeah, there's a lot of titles. University. Is that all you got, Terrell?
One and done.
Colorado. That's your one take, Colorado. Well,
hey.
Thanks.
Well,
Colorado.
What was that? Me and Bach was sitting there at the producer's room in there where we have our outer chit chat and stuff. But I came across an article that showed more vehicles than usual at the University of Florida, where they are paying big time money because every one of their kids in there had SRTs challenges. So it had to be 30 of them outside the university. So
SRTs and challengers?
Yeah. So just imagine how much these kids are actually spending on these cars, because some of these cars are $100,000 cars.
Yeah, but you know what? You know me in cars,
yeah.
Right? I don't know. I think that's the worst investment, you know what I mean, that these young men can make. I get it, but it's the worst investment. Now, if they're just being given cars, right, to drive, that's a different story. But if they're actually taking dollars out that could be earmarked for something else, so now because I want to go get a Hellcat, I'm spending $800 to $1,000 a month for a Hellcat when I could be spending $300 for a Honda, because I'm in school. I mean, what's it really about?
Well, hey, you know, and they can afford it. Hey, more power to you. But I'm just saying,
yeah, we can afford it for these 5 years that we were getting free money from the government.
But yeah, if you want an $80,000 car and you making what $250,000 to $500,000 that year, go get your dream car. Because it's something that you worked hard for.
These are 18, 19, 20, 21, 22.
Okay, but
they ain't worked at all.
This is what college football has turned into.
I get that part now.
I mean, hey, Deion, what you think Reggie Bush was probably driving in college, but he didn't get any money? He didn't get NIL.
Oh, he got NIL. That's why he got NIL.
So, I mean, I'll be happy. I mean, what? What you call those driving a Lamborghini? One of them had a G-Wagon. Deion Sanders' son has a $100,000.
Yeah, you can't count that. You can't count that. Tesla. You cannot count that.
Deion money. Yeah,
that's Deion money. Deion's been having money for years. So you can't say that his sons are getting, they've got that level of vehicle because they're at Colorado. That ain't true. That's not true.
Players, by the way,
players ain't got Gucci, no bad cars.
Gucci bags, Gucci shoes, Louis Vuitton shoes.
Dumb.
Well, you just dumb. Say that, but that's Marvin Harrison's son. You don't think he can do it?
Well, I'm going to say that again. Marvin Harrison money is different money. Okay. Marvin Harrison is making millions in NIL. That's different money. He got money. Matter of fact, his dad got so much money that he or his son's son probably don't have to work. If they did it the right way, and I believe they did, but now him being NIL, he ain't got to do nothing. He made millions of dollars in college.
And he's going to be a top five pick.
That's my point. Okay? But you tell me, what guy in there has the potential to be a top five pick? It may be only one come to your mind.
Are you saying the University of Florida, by the way?
Yeah, the University of Florida.
They've been struggling. They're not doing well.
Hey, I guess
they're terrible.
They're not a good team.
Well, hey.
That's why.
But, you know, just saying. Drive by the University of Nebraska out there, parking lot, what you see?
Trucks, couple Challengers, Chargers, everything over there. I'm not saying that. I'm saying do it. Be smart, okay? You're never going to get this free money again. Okay, and you can say it's not free. I get it, but I'm saying, anytime someone gives you money for doing something that you can deem it work, but they're getting an education, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, how much is the education worth?
Well, that's pretty expensive. Yeah,
they're getting room and board. How much is room and board worth?
Very expensive.
They're getting scholarship check. Do you know how much the scholarship check is now?
About $2,400.
$2,400 to $2,600 a month. You know what we would have been. You know, anyway, so if the scholarship checks is $2,600, now let's say the minimum amount, I don't know, guys. You have to call Matt Davidson, 1890, and get that information. I don't know what these guys are getting. I don't dig into that. I think that's their personal business, and hopefully whatever they're getting is enough to make them give everything they got on the football field. Everything.
Just saying, even if you're a lower-level guy, you can get, what, $10,000 a month?
$5,000
a month with the scholarship checks, that's $7,000 a month. I mean, hey.
Okay.
Now I
think about this. Now, look. Listen. Look, we go to work every day now.
I can get the cheapest apartment box and still pay $3,000-$4,000 for that SRT that they want to pay for. I ain't got to throw all my money into it. You know what I'm saying? Because you know why? I'm going to make this money all year.
This is why he's here today.
Yeah.
That way of thinking.
Okay.
You do the math.
But
if you're here,
let's say you're here.
Let's say you're here 2 years.
BJ, I paid $200 for my car. Okay?
We ain't talking about you. That was 40 years ago. We're talking about now.
Okay.
We're talking about what these kids are doing right now.
This 30 is what years ago.
So 40. So, yeah, I know it's 30, but I just want to exaggerate the 40.
29 when I met you, though.
Whatever.
Okay.
Yeah. See, you trying to throw me off so I can mess up my take, man.
Hey.
Why are you doing that?
CTE. I don't know.
Why are you doing that?
Let's go.
Wait, but why are you doing? What was I saying? Oh, you don't know.
I forgot.
You wasn't listening. What was I saying?
You were talking about his car.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, not back then.
We're not talking about your back then bucket. Talking about that white Oldsmobile piece of junk.
It was maroon.
Buick, whatever it was. It was a turd. Okay? It was. A turd.
Let's go.
Driving around in the turd. He liked to have people. He loved people riding around with him, too. Mm. Come on, y'all. Let's go. Did the windows work? All the windows working?
Yeah.
Did everything work in it? Lights work?
Yeah.
And then you had $2,000 worth of system in a $200 car. Think about that. You can hear him coming.
Oh, yeah.
He paid $200 for the car, $2,000 for the system.
No, that was a homemade system.
Yeah, I know. Whatever. You still pay for it.
Like VJ said, some house
speed. Some house speed.
Trying to tell you. Whole trunk full.
24.
So here we are. Let's just do the math real quick. If you're in an SRT 8, 9 times out of 10, you're paying $1,000 a month. Which, that's not, if you're getting $5,000, what percent is that? 20%? So that's 20% of your money, You ain't talked about insurance. How much is insurance? Have you tried to get insurance as an 18-year-old? 21-year-old? I can tell you right now, my son's 26 years old. He got a car from me. Tried to go get full coverage insurance. He not try, he did. It lasted 2 months. Guess how much he had to pay?
About two something.
$430 a month.
Woo.
Jeez.
For full coverage insurance. Right? There's no, for him, I pay $120 for full coverage. He has to pay four something. So now let's call it $1,500.
The mortgage payment.
Okay. So now, and I know all these people out here listening. If all y'all make $1,500, if y'all can throw away, please text in 402-464-5685. If you can afford to throw away $1,500 a month, can you?
I do that now. I'm a kid.
So that's throwing it away.
Hey, I'm a grandpa. I'm a grandfather.
That, you don't have
I'm a grandfather. Thank you. That's all you need to know.
Is that throwing it away?
Yeah. No, I'm giving it away.
You're blessing your kid.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're not throwing that away.
Yeah, I'm just being a great parent. See, he's got a great granddad.
He's got a comeback for everything.
I don't have a comeback.
Yeah. Did you throw $1,500 a month away?
Oh, no, no.
I mean, Just think about it.
How much you throw away a month?
Nowhere near that type of money. If I give you $500, I'm trying to figure out how did I do that? So maybe about $500.
Keno.
No, but I won, buddy. I won. I won. 93.7 The Ticket. We'll be right back. I'm ready for some pitch.
Home for sports talk on the FM dial. Also online at theticketfm.com.
On the internet.
KNTK FM Firth, 93.7 The Ticket.
For over 15 years, Integrated Life Choices has empowered individuals with disabilities in Lincoln and throughout Nebraska. They provide comprehensive services from group homes and independent living services to job training, ensuring fulfilling lives for those that they serve. Now, they're inviting you to join their mission. If you're passionate about making a difference in the lives of people with developmental disabilities, explore rewarding career opportunities with them. Learn more about their services and apply today at www.ilc.net. Be a part of Integrated Life Choices, where your work truly changes lives.
Hi, folks. Sean Callahan here for Koppel Chevrolet GMC, and the Chevrolet and GMC Truck Month is now underway. We've got huge savings in Louisville. Get $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months on select models. Yes, you heard right. That's $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months happening right now at Koppel. So take that short money-saving drive down 144th Street or check us out online at koppelcars.com. You'll be glad. Glad you did. All deals with roof credit. Stock number G214773.
Are you looking to get into the electrical construction industry or wanting a new scene? The Electrical Workers of Local Union 265 are now hiring licensed journeymen and apprentices and are offering great pay and benefits. Call Mike at 402-875-1034 to apply. Start your electrical career today.
Rico here with HIS Auto Care at 70th and Van Dorn, letting you know HIS is a great place to bring your vehicle for service. With superior service bumper to bumper, will treat your vehicle like it's your mother's. Doesn't get any better than that. So call 402-488-8934 and HIS Auto will make you glad you did. 5% off, mention this ad, and for sure your mother be proud you called. 402-488-8934, HIS Auto Care, 7th and Van Doren. God bless you.
If you're in Seward or Milford, listen up. Select Plumbing is now servicing your area with no trip charges from Lincoln. Select Plumbing works on a variety of issues for your home and business, including general plumbing, water heaters, faucet and fixture repair, underground sewer and water repairs, backflow testing, and more. Keep your property free from leaks and other issues. Call today for a free estimate, 402-560-6197. It's not just Lincoln, Waverly, and the surrounding area anymore. It's also Seward and Milford with no trip charges. Contact Select Plumbing to inquire at 402-560-6197.
Spring is here and it's time to wake up Judson. Judson Irrigation is eager and ready to get your sprinkler system up and running for the season. Judson's technicians will check for winter damage, adjust your sprinkler heads, and show you how to set your controller for effective sprinkling coverage. The Judson Irrigation Team is here for you. Stay safe.
Keep summer green. Call Judson Irrigation 402-420-6277 or judsonirrigation.com.
Sandhills Global is hiring. With their fast-paced, growing culture, they have hundreds of new openings in sales, marketing, traveling support, software development, web design, and more. Full-time roles offer a 4.5-day work week, along with flexible internships in most areas. Career and internship opportunities are available at our global headquarters in Lincoln, Nebraska. Find your fit today at www.sandhills.jobs.
Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits is now open in Lincoln. Shop our expansive collection of wine, beer, spirits, and cigars at 5040 North 27th Street. From top-shelf liquor to crowd-favorite beer, Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits has a beverage for every taste and every budget. Plus, join our loyalty program to earn rewards and save on future purchases. Shop Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits at 5040 North 27th Street in Lincoln. That's 5040 North 27th Street.
Ever wish you had another light switch on the other side of the room on a dark night? How much better would you sleep at night if you had a ceiling fan in your room? The High Electric Service Department is here to make your electrical what-ifs a reality. Whether you're looking to replace some outdated light fixtures or brighten up your counters with under-cabinet lighting, High Electric can handle all types of residential electrical installations and services. Give Erica a call at 402-466-6606 or visit high-electric.com to get started.
Tanner's Bar and Grill is the perfect place to watch the NCAA tournament from the round of 64 all the way to the championship. Bring your friends and family in to enjoy Tanner's delicious hamburgers, chicken lips, and daily specials, and wash it down with one of their tons of options of beers. You'll never have an issue finding the game, as there are TVs everywhere throughout the space. So get in early, grab your spot, and settle in for a day of NCAA tournament basketball at Tanner's Bar and Grill, 30th and Yankee Hill.
This is 93.7 The Ticket.
Look at me short. Look at me short. I'm the captain now.
Three-time national champion, Vershawn Jackson.
Touchdown. Vershawn Jackson, number 34, gets the touchdown.
Terrell Farley.
Defending Terrell Farley,
who last week in his first start was a holy terror. Number 43.
And Jake Bakovin.
I've talked a few cats. They said that Bak got some game, man.
Coming at you live from the Koppel Chevrolet GMC studios in the heart of Lincoln, America. On air and online at theticketfm.com. Powered by Bauer. Here he is, Vershawn Jackson.
Welcome back to the Captain Show.
Yeah. 93.7. SoCal, appreciate these tacos. Steak tacos.
Yes, sir.
Oh, man, I'm glad I came to the shop. They take care of us. So, SoCal, get down there and get some of these good tacos. We appreciate you guys taking care of us. I said I need to eat some tacos. So I'm getting a little steak in me, a little meat for once.
Is Bob coming tomorrow?
I don't know.
We got to find out.
That's a great question. Great question. No, we got some Nebraska basketball news.
Well, yeah, it's from yesterday. Don't sound the alarms because I know people are freaking out.
Boy, but, I'm not sounding them, but yeah. Well, I didn't hear about it.
Well,
there's certain people like me that all don't necessarily hear about stuff.
I know. I just want to say when we're talking about the transfer portal, people are going to say, oh, not again. Well, it was yesterday again. That Nebraska lost DeMarcus Lawrence to the transfer portal. Of course, Nebraska's already lost a few guys with C.J. Wilcher, Blaze Cada, and so I mean you're already losing in Kasey Tominaga and Josiah Alec to graduation. It just feels like, you know, Ramel Lloyd Jr., another name that they hit the transfer portal. It's modern day college basketball, but it is you feel like you're. I said when Wilcher transferred, it's like, I was like, all right, from there, if you stop it there, it's not too bad. Nothing too disruptive. It's a player. So that's two out of their eight man rotation now that transferred, as well as two guys that are graduating.
Pay for it. Pay for it. Pay for it. pay for it. You got it. You got the money. Go out and get the players. You went and paid your coach, didn't you? We went and paid the coach to get a coach extension.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you went and get Horberger extension. Pay for the players now.
Yeah, I think Fred can go out there and sell this team just by speaking about the record they had last year. Hey, we was 19-1 at home. We did go to the NCAA tournament. We got to get better though. So he can sell that.
I don't know if they recover though.
Yeah, I mean,
how do they recover? Well, they lost. Listen, the guys that they lost. Those are critical.
Well, I think outside of Wilcher and now Lawrence, it's
no. What about the guys that left?
Well, it's healthy enough. Well, I mean, the guys that graduated, like Tominaga.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Again, so out of that, you're losing like four out of your 8-man rotation. There's some guys that are leaving, like an Eli Rice that maybe you thought would be part of your rotation moving forward. I mean, they still have this base, but I mean, if you're talking about Rink Mass and Juwan Gary, Sam Hoiberg, you know, Matar Jope is going to be returning. So, you've got a few guys on that team, but Bryce Williams. It is. I mean,
do you think those are going to be the five starters?
I think obviously you have Rink Mass and Bryce, and Juwan Gary. I think that's your core. If you lose one of those, then it really is trying to sound the alarms and kind of think, okay, how are you going to put this together? But to Fred Hoiberg's credit, last year, we didn't know who Bryce Williams or Rink Mass was. We didn't know who, sure. You know, so they did a good job with portal combat, as people are calling it nowadays, last season. Should be able to do the same here. But part of the excitement for this season and making this run was there would be a big part of this team coming back. And now it's not a big part. It's just a part.
A part. Just a little part. Yeah. But, I mean, listen, you. I would be concerned if there wasn't a transfer portal and if we didn't have a bunch of money to spend. Where we know now, nobody's like, oh, no, everybody's all scared of NIL and asking for money. Now it's like a free-for-all. We need money. 100% of the donation that you donate to, blah, 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 will go straight to the athlete.
But when you say we, as in, isn't the basketball kind of NIL money is different from the football?
No.
Or is all together?
1890.
Yeah. Now it's 1890.
Yeah. 1890 runs all that. So it's 1890's responsibility to make sure that they spend the money that they have responsibly and on the best quality player. You know, I mean, just because you spend money might not be the best quality player, but you might be able to get a guy of value or you might have to spend a little bit. But I asked you guys that question earlier about what person on this football team could you see, if you can envision anything, a guy getting drafted in the first round? Who would it be?
On this football team?
On this football team right now across the roster.
Boy, you'd need a monster year from Robinson or Hutmacher.
Stop it. Stop it. And no matter what kind of year they have, I still wouldn't believe that. What type of, I mean, Sue type numbers?
Yeah, you're talking big numbers.
Yeah, Sue type numbers. But, I mean, the guy, the biggest upside, if you really ask me, who has the potential to be, those guys don't have potential to be a first-round draft pick, though.
Well, they're near the end of their career. It'd be their last season.
Top 10 pick.
It's hard to see that, yeah.
Real. That's it. I said potential.
Mm.
Right? Mm-hmm. Now, there's some other guys that show us. What? There's some other guys.
I was going to tell you something, but you go ahead.
What? Go ahead and tell me.
Yeah, he won't be here that long. He's about 2 years to come back to Georgia. Say, man. Talk about
hey, cut his mic. Cut his mic, Bach. Which one is it? Cut
down. There down. It is.
All right. Don't you say that again. You hear me? Turn it back on. Don't you say that again. You hear what I said?
Hey. Nobody's loyal. Hey, Trev.
They are. Now. Well, Trev is a different animal now. We're not going to talk about Trev here. Trev is dead to us right now, okay? Right. Trev's from Iowa. We ain't going to talk about that.
But how much, if you're a coach and you're looking at the especially, you know, basketball is one thing, football is another. And we talked about the other day, Matt Rhule did a great job with retention so far with this football team. We'll see what happens after the spring. We'll see some guys that probably aren't happy with where they are. But in any case, do you even plan for 4 years ahead with guys when you're recruiting them anymore? I mean, it's basically a one-year deal now.
Yeah, the way football is set up now, because you never know if a guy's happy or unhappy.
It's a one-year deal because coaches, head coaches necessarily don't go in with the truth. Give them as much money as you can. This is what you're worth to me, and we don't want you to go anywhere. We're not recruiting you so you can get in the transfer portal. it might not work out for you for the first year. If you don't work hard, it might not work out for you for the second year. But if you understand how hard work beat talent when talent don't work hard, year three, four, and five, you might be able to write your own ticket. That's all. You don't buy that?
Nope.
Why?
Just don't, because it's like I said, like Box said, it's a year to year thing. Hey, if I'm not happy, we're not winning.
How many people we lost off this year's team?
I mean, that's where they gonna go, VJ?
How many starters?
Where they gonna go?
They can go to FAMU.
I haven't seen one player from Nebraska get any good luck.
Listen to me.
Going to another school.
Yeah, is getting courted by a lot of NFL teams, a ton of them.
Mm-hmm.
So he went to FAMU and he's getting juice.
Last year. He got one more year, don't he?
Yeah, he got one more year, but he might be coming out. But my point is, you can get juice. It depends on what the end game is. What is your end game? Is your end game to say, oh, I was at Nebraska for 5 years and never got a chance to play, but boy, it was fun. That's the end game? Because there's a lot of players like that at the University of Nebraska, scholarship or not, that will take a ride on the Reading Railroad just to say they're on Reading Railroad, and they're going to go around to Pennsylvania and Boardwalk and everywhere else and come back and never get a chance to play Monopoly. They keep going around, 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 and they can't buy no pieces. You know how frustrating that'll be if we all in here playing Monopoly, right? You getting your $200 for pass and go, but you don't get to buy a piece of nothing. You're going to lose.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to lose. And it's the same way. You don't, you come to Nebraska, I would tell them, look, if you outwork, I don't care if you're on scholarship or walk-on, you outwork everybody at your position, you're the starter. But if you don't work hard, then you probably could get in. You basically could get in the transfer portal in 2 or 3 years. But I'm recruiting them with honesty, man. I'm not recruiting them on the notion that you're my starter. Oh, yeah, I'm going to put you as my starter. Unless I know for a fact I've got nothing there, like at quarterback. If you know for a fact you got nothing there, you know you're going to got to recruit a starter.
That's the easiest said been done. But yeah, if you look at the facts from the last 2-3 years of this portal, I mean, you got players leaving 10-2 teams to go somewhere else, just to go to a 13-0 team. I mean.
It ain't working out.
Yeah, it ain't working out because now it's just like the kid from Iowa. Okay, he leaves Alabama. Guess what he's doing now?
Hmm.
He's going back to Alabama.
You mean what?
The offensive lineman.
He went to Iowa. Proctor.
Yeah. He committed. He was getting recruited by Iowa out of high school because he's from Iowa.
Yeah.
But he committed to Alabama. Played 15 games as a freshman.
Sure.
Transferred back to Iowa. Got $100K up front or something. Now he's transferring.
Did he play at Iowa?
No. He just left in January.
Got a cup of coffee.
Now he's going back to Alabama.
See what I'm saying? So he got $100,000.
Yep. Going back to Alabama.
What? To do what?
To play.
Yeah, no, he didn't play.
He started at Alabama. He transferred to Iowa for about 2 weeks.
Now he's going back.
Transferred back to Alabama.
Okay, so he wasn't at Iowa long enough to.
No.
Oh.
He got the money.
Yeah, he got the bag. I'd have took the bag too. Man, these kids, I mean, if you got an opportunity, man, for these schools to give you $100,000, you take the same opportunity that Trev Albers took. Soon as he got a chance to see across the street. But again, if you're recruiting against that, you got to make sure that conversation is had.
And that's something we have to teach our kids. You can't take money up front and then just leave. I mean, if you see that, that's like theft. I mean, knowing it's college football,
that is theft.
That's dangerous.
Do you ever think about these kids like working out a deal where, say, for instance, they said, VJ, we're going to give you $10,000 a month, right? And I said, listen, I don't want the $10,000. I'm good on my scholarship check. The $2,600 is good enough. Plus, if I might get a little secular NIL deal or whatever from someone else. But here's my point. If they're going to give me $10,000 in NIL deal, I can do math real quick. In my mind, especially if I had a son, I don't care how good he is. Hold up, dog. You get to develop. You get $10,000. And then you get to go to the NFL. What we're going to do is we're going to take that $10,000 a month, which will be $120 a year, and we're going to put it in a CD for 5 years. How much is that? $600,000. $600,000? Yeah, $600,000. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, at the end of your 5 years, if somebody told me that at the end of 5 years, whatever that $600,000 that I put into the CD, whatever that was, it doesn't matter what it is. Matter of fact, just give me the $600,000 back. Mm-hmm. You don't make it to the NFL and you get a chance to get a check for $600,000. Does that set your life up?
Oh, yeah.
That's all I'm saying. Even if they save half, that's $300,000. Don't do anything. Just save. That's my question to this NIL, to these young men. Are you saving money or are you spending it all in a big time free for all to say, look at me,
living my best life?
Oh my God.
And you can't do nothing. Living my best life.
See, that's what I'm saying. That's why.
Come on in, fellas, the jacuzzi is in the back.
That's why we're thinking.
Hey, you only be young once, right? So
yeah, that's it. Hey,
only one run through college.
Yeah, that's whatever, dude. I mean, like I said before, I wish I had listened. I'm not gonna say nobody told me about money because I did get advised, but I was young, and you know, when you ain't really, you come from no money, and you get some quarters, you want to go spend, but I think at the end of the day, somebody has to be the voice in the room. Somebody has to look out for these young men's future, have vision to see that, hey, son, 2%, 1% of all college athletes get an opportunity to go to the league. Are you going to be the 1% or the 99%? Because I can tell you now, if you're a part of the 1%, you better be breaking your neck and busting your ass to be the best football player that you can be on a 24-hour scale. Mind, body, soul. Period. But if you're part of the 99%, you know what I mean, that didn't get the opportunity to go to the NFL, that sniffed the NFL but didn't even, so listen, there's a lot of guys that didn't even sniff it. Can't even say they was in the locker room. Hmm. We can say we was in the locker room, right?
Yeah.
Right? A couple different teams. So yeah. I just want them to be smarter because I'm hearing horror stories right now. I'm hearing tax horror stories. I'm hearing horror stories of these young men when they get done playing and the government says no more money for you. What do they do? Where do they turn? What happens? If your kids called you today and you was like, you know what? Y'all 5 years is up. I can't give you no more money.
Well, hopefully they went and got their education as well, besides getting the money, because you still got to go to school.
I agree.
So hopefully
Having your education don't necessarily mean you're going to get a job.
I mean, you got to save your money right.
So you used to getting $10,000 a month, and then all of a sudden the whole spigot is turned off, and now you want, what $10,000 a month job you going to go to? Give me one degree that you can get a degree and go work, and your first job out the gates is $100,000. Please, I'll wait. Text line's open. I'll wait for it.
Might be going to 8 years of school or something.
I do have one job, but I don't even think in that one job that I'm thinking about coming fresh out the gates, can you make $100,000? I just don't think so. I don't think you can make $100,000. I think it takes time to build yourself up to making that $100,000 in sales. But if there is, go to the text line, see if it is. If there is, tell me what that is. What job can you get done with a bachelor's degree, a bachelor's, and your first job you make $100,000?
Being Little Red.
I don't think
Little Red in there for free. Yeah. He in there for the air conditioner. I'm just simply saying, what's the text line? Yeah, I don't believe that there's any job that you can make, you know what I mean, without having some type of history or background. You know, I was going to say car dealership, right? Mm-hmm. Because a lot of car guys make $100,000+ a year. But if you fresh out of college and you go to be a car guy, you got to get trained up again.
Well, it should be noted, too. I think when we think about these NIL deals, we think about, you know, all these guys getting all this money, when really it's a few of the guys getting all the money and then the rest of the team getting some supplemental income. But it's not life-changing money. So.
What's supplemental? Whoa, 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 whoa. You mean to tell me, hold on, Terrell, Don't watch this, Bach. Mm-hmm. You're getting $5,000 free. Is that life-changing money for you? If you got $5,000 extra for free.
A month?
Just not, and I say free.
It's just one-time payment.
No. For the next 5 years.
Is that a what?
Is that life-changing?
Yeah.
Like, if you got an extra $5,000 a month for the next 5 years, that's life-changing.
But that's what I'm saying. I don't know how many guys get $5,000 a month on NIL.
Bro, I would imagine that. Every guy on scholarship. The gig is up, man. It's out. Everybody knows you got to use NIL. Mm-hmm. So I would imagine that every player on scholarship is definitely on NIL.
Yeah, so I'm making $88,000 a year, $50,000, $100,000.
Some of these guys are already rated in high school worth $43,000. So I can't imagine there's guys that's on the team that's not getting, you know, at least $2,500 a month extra. Low-end guys.
With scholarship checks, Bach.
Man, that's scholarship checks will help.
But that's $5,000. Yeah, if you only get $2,500 or $7,500, if you're getting that and you do the math, $7,500 times 12. Huh? That's 75,000 plus 15,000. Huh? That's $90,000. Answer me this. At what point and what time do they have the money or the time to spend the money? When would it? No, you know what we teach them? To become compulsive buyers.
Well, it depends what university you go to.
I don't care what university.
Because for us, we can spend it on Christmas, New Year's, because we're not playing in bowl games. But the other players can, you know, fly home for Christmas. You know, fly somebody up.
Yeah, $90,000 and no guidance is a recipe for disaster. So I hope we got some policies and procedures, and I think we do. I'm just simply saying I'm hearing horror stories from a few schools. From coaches and players alike of this NIL going completely different. Like some guys being told that they're going to get X, get to the school, and they get Y. Anyway, 93.7 The Ticket. I'm with Bach in the black shirt, and we are rolling the fastest 2 hours of radio. We'll be right back.
Crazy. 93.7 The Ticket. Fox KFXL Weather. Sponsored by John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning.
Your Lincoln forecast for today. Some clouds this morning will give way to sunshine this afternoon. It'll be breezy, snapping high around 55. Tonight, mainly clear and breezy. Overnight low around 33. And tomorrow, we'll see mainly sunny skies and more wind. An afternoon high around 54. Meteorologist Kyle Klecker for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits is now open in Lincoln. Shop our expansive collection of wine, beer, spirits, and cigars at 5040 North 27th Street. From top-shelf liquor to crowd-favorite beer, Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits has a beverage for every taste and every budget. Plus, join our loyalty program to earn rewards and save on future purchases. Shop Wall-to-Wall Wine and Spirits at 5040 North 27th Street in Lincoln. That's 5040 North 27th Street.
Rico here with HIS Auto Care at 70th and Van Dorn, letting you know HIS is a great place to bring your vehicle for service. With superior service bumper to bumper, we'll treat your vehicle like it's your mother's. Doesn't get any better than that. So call 402-488-8934 and HIS Auto will make you glad you did. 5% off, mention this ad, and for sure your mother be proud you called. 402-488-8934, HIS Auto Care, 70th and Van Dorn. God bless you.
Rosie Sports Bar and Grill. Open for lunch and dinner at 1501 Center Park Road.
Sick of being upsold at gyms?
My guy, you're currently a base member? For $90 more, I can upgrade you to our Shred membership. For $130 more, you'll be a Swole member. And for just $300 more, you'll reach Sweat Platinum.
At Planet Fitness, you'll get energy without the upsell. Never pushy, always free fitness training and equipment for every workout. It's fitness that fits your budget. Join Planet Fitness for just $1 down and $10 a month. Cancel anytime. Deal ends Friday, April 12th. See Home Club for details.
Spring is here, and it's time to wake up Judson. Judson Irrigation is eager and ready to get your sprinkler system up and running for the season. Judson's technicians will check for winter damage, adjust your sprinkler heads, and show you how to set your controller for effective sprinkling coverage. The Judson Irrigation team is here for you. Stay safe.
Keep summer green. Call Judson Irrigation 402-420-6277 or judsonirrigation.com.
Spring is here. It's time to get back outside and into proper shoes this year. Brown Shoe Fit is the place to buy this spring with their sale on athletic shoes. Get $15 off any regular price athletic shoes with respected brands like Hoka, Brooks, New Balance, and On Running. And don't forget, Brown's carries a large arrangement of sizes and widths to fit your feet properly. Start your spring off right at Brown Shoe Fit, just south of 66 and Q in Lincoln.
Tanner's Bar and Grill is the perfect place to watch the NCAA tournament from the round of 64 all the way to the championship. Bring your friends and family in to enjoy Tanner's delicious hamburgers, chicken lips, and daily specials, and wash it down with one of their tons of options of beers. You'll never have an issue finding the game, as there are TVs everywhere throughout the space. So get in early, grab your spot, and settle in for a day of NCAA tournament basketball at Tanner's Bar and Grill, 30th and Yankee Hill.
Are you tired of living in pain? It's time to take control. At Prairie Orthopedic and Plastic Surgery, we're your one-stop shop for expert care in Lincoln. From broken bones to complex reconstruction, our skilled team will help you get back on track. Visit prairieortho.com today and discover why we're the trusted choice for thousands of patients. Don't let pain hold you back. Take the first step towards a better, pain-free life with Prairie Orthopedic and Plastic Surgery, where healing begins. Call 402-489-4700.
Load up on meat and more this spring at the Mercado by Certified Piedmontese at 84th and Havelock. This week's specials through April 2nd is buy one, get one free on 8-ounce flat iron steaks. Limit 4 per visit. And don't forget about lunch on Fired Up Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Locations on 84th and Havelock and 30th and Yankee Hill in Lincoln, or 168th and Maple in Omaha. Get to the Mercado today for the best meat in town.
The Omaha Supernovas are back in action this Tuesday, April 2nd, versus the San Diego Mojo at the Viejas Arena in San Diego. The Mullen Motors pregame show with Derek Pearson and Renee Saunders starts at 8 p.m. with first serve at 9. Make sure to tune in to the Next Ag Appraisal and Realty postgame show right after the match ends. Catch all the action on your flagship station, 93.7 The Ticket, and statewide on the Supernovas radio network.
For over 15 years, Integrated Life Choices has empowered individuals with disabilities in Lincoln and throughout Nebraska. They provide comprehensive services from group homes and independent living services to job training, ensuring fulfilling lives for those that they serve. Now, they're inviting you to join their mission. If you're passionate about making a difference in the lives of people with developmental disabilities, explore rewarding career opportunities with them. Learn more about their services and apply today at www.ilc.net. Be a part of Integrated Life Choices, where your work truly changes lives.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
We apologize. We got construction going on. We're trying to get our sound system and all that. Young men in here handling business, trying to get us all squared away. So we want to apologize in advance. We got stuff going on around here, y'all. But I think you guys understand. Go to text line real quick, Pox. What we got?
Money G in Kansas says, what's going to happen in college athletics when the NIL starts to dry up?
How would it dry up?
Well, there is a thought among some folks that it, you know, maybe this is because it's new. It's your chance to go out there and help your university. That a lot of people are intrigued and they're trying to help it when they can. But I guess if you donate $3 million to get a quarterback and then that quarterback doesn't play for 2 years and transfers, And then the university comes back and says, well, we need another quarterback. You might not be so ready to do so. So, I mean, that's an extreme example, obviously. But the idea that you know, maybe the newness of this or getting burnt on a deal will eventually wear some of the boosters thin and they might not want to do it anymore.
Well, here's the real question. Are they, the money that they're getting in NIL, they ain't just doling it out. I would imagine they're investing it, right? They got to try to make it work, because if I give money to something, right, none of it you can't write it off. I'm just giving. Now, we give this stuff all the time. I don't know why we would ever think that it would go away. I don't think it would go away. I think when it goes away, it's going away from a top down.
Well, name, image, and likeness, too. Remember, you're supposed to be doing some sort of service or something, you know, to use your name. Or your image. It's not supposed to be pay for play, but it's
pay for
play. It's pretty much walk across the street and we'll give you, pay for play.
Yeah, what do you expect when you think everybody, every institution wants to win? At what cost is the real question.
Giving them profit of the revenue, that's one thing they probably going to start doing. I know I heard schools talking about that a lot, but, you know, that can help in one way for the football program.
I agree with that. If they're part of the program, give them a little kickback every year.
Yeah.
You said it's our 30-year reunion or the first championship,
mm-hmm.
which would have been the third championship.
Mm-hmm.
Can we raise some money at the game, whatever game we do, for all of us to get a little NIL money?
Yeah, just come by and throw $20 in that.
You're saying, you know what I'm saying? Can we be like at church and take up a collection?
You could try.
You know what I'm saying? This is for, and then listen, we take up the collection and say, this is for the former Husker Alumni Gear Fund. How you like that?
Are you buying gear, are you getting gear with it?
Yeah, no, we'll buy a bunch of gear, and then if guys are in town, they need some gear, they come by here. We market. We know, hey, we just gave you a sweatsuit, Terrell. We can't give you another sweatsuit. We just gave you a pair of shoes, Terrell. We're not going to give you another pair. You got to wait for a year. You know, so maybe they come and get outfitted, you know what I'm saying, a nice little outfit once a year.
Maybe I just need a hookup for life. I just need that easy job that I can just sit down and relax in the air and
it's too late. Yeah. That ship has sailed.
No, it's not. It's
you have to play football.
No.
Then that's the one easy job that you had in your life where you could skate free and make the most money. You can't do that anywhere else. What? Who you going to tell me you can?
What's that?
Skate and make a bunch of money. Like, listen, we played football to get beat up. We didn't play football for the scholarship check. We played for the love of the game. Listen, the old people in the room is the reason why it's messed up, because they thought at the top, West, we better give them some money. We better give them some money. Now you done open up the floodgates. Guess what? When teams like Nebraska's doing now start getting this money in, and when you mix understanding people with understanding money, it should be a great, should be easy. I'm done, Rand.
Well, that's why now with the transfer portal too, a lot of this is just, it's a business decision. It's, you know, it's like pro sports. There's not necessarily loyalty to your team. It's okay. What are we trading off here? Can I get a better deal somewhere else? And, you know, maybe it's always been like that to a degree, but now, like you said, it's just opened up and everybody's eyes are open to it. And so it's hard to, like, I can't, it's not like back in the day when somebody transferred and you'd be like, oh, why did they do it? Here's all the, like, it's obvious what the reasons are for. And you just go, okay, well, I guess they're just trying to improve their life. It doesn't always work. I mean, it's not always greener on the other side, but.
What stops me, Vershawn Jackson, a businessman, from maybe catching one of these players out somewhere and saying, hey, look, I got $1,000. I want you to just come by for $1,000 and just hang out. I'm just looking in that situation, right? He come to the shop. I shoot him $1,000. Who recorded it? Was it text? Did I give him a check? Did I give him cash? Who's reporting it? Is that legal? According to the NCAA? Is that legal?
I don't believe so.
You're a fan.
I'm just trying to figure this thing out. Because we seem to think that when we be like 1890, which I think 1890 is going to have to be phenomenal in what they do. But there's also other monies outside of 1890 that some of these young men are getting.
Well, you see Jeff Sim had Taco Bell.
Amigos.
Yeah, he had everything.
We need to blow Amigos up right now for that. There's a part of that. I'm just playing. That was one of our mainstays. Amigos, I'm sorry. Is it still over there?
Yeah.
Is it? When's the last time you've been? I would never eat that again. No, I'm just playing. I would go get a Taco-rito. Is that what it is?
I don't know.
What's those little meat little roll things they have? You know, the little Churro? Small little, is that what that is? Yeah. Remember those little meat rolls we used to get back in the day? What was it called?
You can buy them at Quick Trip.
What are they called? Meat rolls. Something like that.
Taco rolls? I don't know.
I don't know. Taquitos? Go ahead.
Give me taquitos.
Yeah, let's go.
Crisp meat burrito. Is that what you're
talking about? Crisp meat.
Yeah, Eric. Who said that? Eric comes in with
that. Oh my God, Eric. Eric, I knew you was a super agent. You was around when we was around, Eric. I know it. Nobody knows about crisp meats. Them crisp meats is bomb. Come on, give me some text line, man. I want to.
0177 says, did I see two grown men attempt to race down the sidewalk during the break?
I won. No. I got out of the blocks on him. He figured it's over with. I tell you, when you run a short race, if you mess up out the gates, it's over with.
You both had a false start. He jumped. I didn't jump.
He jumped twice.
Offensive, defense, different.
Nobody
deals,
jumped twice. I jumped once.
Okay, just, the other time, and I just hit the gun.
I hit the gun right on time. I wasn't even down.
That's your fault. He said he was just gonna say go.
I was saying on your march, get set.
How do you get to say on your march, get set, go?
I was telling Bob how to say it. Wasn't that right,
yeah,
Bob?
Yeah, we'll do it again.
Wait to a warm up.
We'll run all the way down the block. We'll do it again. Yeah. Just listen though. You see that little green pole right there? That's the finish line because we need time to stop.
Yeah, yeah. They're gonna see you sliding on the ground.
Yeah, you almost ran into the street there. You can slow yourself down.
I'm trying to tell you. That's what I'm saying. You know what I mean? When you hitting that gas pedal, you a little bit faster, man. The slowdown is real. Come on, man. Read some of these text lines, Bach. What you got?
I don't know if there's much more on the text line, but I did want to ask you guys about this because Adam Carriker had Luke McCaffrey on the other day, and he mentioned that he was never asked to move to wideout at Nebraska. I think we all kind of put that together in our own heads because it was pretty obvious. It doesn't take a coach to see that, you know, he could have helped athletically for Nebraska back then without being at quarterback. Kind of think back to the 2020, 2021 seasons.
Told you.
Is that a surprise to you guys? Because he obviously transferred to Louisville, tried quarterback out there, transferred to Rice, tried quarterback out there before finally moving to wide receiver. And he was all conference this last year. He's looking to go to the NFL now.
Well, maybe the coach did a right decision and said, hey, your quarterback days are over. We need you to move here. I mean, I think you'll be better here. I mean, you see the same thing with Eric Crouch when he tried to, you know, from the pros, he did it. But at the same time, Coach Rule should have been trying to put that in Jeff Sims. Coach Rule should have been trying to put that in Jeff Sims' head. Hey, we need you at receiver. I mean,
we don't need him on the football field at all. Don't do it. Anything can happen with him. If Paul hit him in the hands, tipped up, pick six. No, Terrell, no.
That's wrong.
It's a bad take. It's a bad take, Terrell.
See, but McCaffrey, they did put him in a few plays against Iowa. Remember the first game against Ohio State in 2020. They, you know, he had a big run in their touchdown drive there. So I mean, it was obvious that it was there, but he said that just came up from at one time in a drill, the running back at a tie shoe or something. So he ran out there. They liked it, so they kind of made a little package out of it. But there was never an idea to switch positions.
I told y'all gonna listen to me one of these days. They never approached him. No coach, Scott Frost preferably, because he's the head coach. Mm-hmm. Never thought to himself, "Hey, his dad was playing the league at receiver." Hey, listen to me. I'm going to get you to the NFL. I know, Mac. Just calm down, Mac. I know. I know you want to play quarterback. I know. But let me give you some examples. It's not where you're going to play a lot longer at receiver than you will in the NFL. If you go at quarterback, you might not go. You don't have a big enough arm, kid.
Is he? He's not in school, is he?
He's coming out.
Yeah, he's just finished.
I thought he was
13 touchdown receptions this past year.
What's wrong with you?
Maybe he can get a good free agency. Hey, like it's, hey,
free agent?
Good. Oh, no. Come on, BJ. That wide receiver's thick.
I got money that say McCaffrey get drafted. Bet 1,000 push-ups.
It's a good bet. It'll be close.
Bet 1,000 push-ups that McCaffrey get drafted. Bet.
I can't do push-ups.
Sit-ups.
All right.
I need to do them anyway.
Three-pointers, Bob.
There it is.
That's 2,000.
I got two birds, 2,000, one shot.
2,000.
Blow!
2,000 set push-up.
Did he go to the combine?
Nope.
Let me look here.
Hold up. If he didn't go to the combine, how many schools was at his pro day?
I thought I saw a picture of him in the combine.
Thank you. Say it again. Say it again.
Combine here. Let's see if we can pull up his numbers.
So, let's see his pro day.
Say it again.
40-yard dash, 4.46. 10-yard split, 1.52. Vert, 36. Broad jump, 10.1. Three-cone drill, 6.7. And 20-yard shuttle, 4.02.
Did he go to the pro day?
He did. Or he went to the combine.
Whoa. Say that again. So he did what?
He did go to the combine.
He did go to the combine? Mm-hmm. Oh. So are you telling...
1,000 athletes go to the combine for sure.
No, it ain't 1,000.
Okay.
It is not. It's like 300. It's not 1,000. No, it's not. I told you, you've been taking bad takes all day today. You won't have a conversation. We're going to the conference room when we get off here. I'm about to help you out.
I'm not going to a conference room. I'm going down O Street.
No, you're going to the conference room.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, because you just tried. What did you just say? Say what you just said again.
It was a mistake.
Okay.
I
appreciate you being honest and saying it was a mistake.
Yeah.
Okay? Because I'm getting a little tired of these mistakes that you're making. Can only keep on making so.
What have you found, Bob?
Well, I'm trying to see like how many wide receivers get drafted per year. According to this site, NFL.com's got him ranked as the 19th wide receiver.
Stop. 19.
Yeah.
Stop. He getting drafted. Even if it's the sixth round, you owe me 1,000 push-ups even.
No, we.
Him 1,000 sit-ups even, maestro.
It ain't happened yet, buddy.
You can say what you want unless something catastrophic happens. Meaning, he goes somewhere, he gets in trouble. His last name is going to get him drafted. What are y'all thinking about?
33 wide receivers drafted last year.
Hey, Bach, I think we lost
that. I think we lost that bet.
That's 1,000 of them, boy. That's a lot.
He's going back to school next year. He pulled his name out the draft. He pulled his name out the draft. He's going back to school, Bach.
But that's what I'm telling you. With the last name McCaffrey, you know. Listen, son, the running back, right? Come on now. Dad, Easy Ed. Come on, man. Come on. Even if he was Mr. Irrelevant, he going to get drafted. Because to be quite honest with you, you know this. A fifth, sixth, seventh round pick ain't no better than the guy that you went and got free agent.
Mm-hmm.
Right? The walk-on NFL guy. He's no better. You just like him more. Okay? I've seen some second round busts that I'm thinking to myself, now ain't that a blimp? What made them go out there and give Mike Cloud, if you guys don't know who Mike Cloud is, you probably won't because you never heard of him in the NFL. But do you know who Mike Cloud is? You heard that name?
No.
Anyway, they went out and picked Mike Cloud in the second round of the draft. Please tell me who Mike Cloud is. Who is he? No one knows. Text line know who Mike Cloud is?
Did he make it? Did he get cut? I seen him.
No, he went second or third round.
I seen a second or third round to get cut.
Yeah, no, they don't cut him immediately. They let him stay 2 or 3 years. They got to. You can't go say Terrell's is my second round pick. You only get 7 picks total, right? You can't say, if you're the GM to the owner, yeah, I picked Terrell in the second round and he's a bust. We want any to get rid of him. Well, you just gave him a $2 million signing bonus. How are you going to do that? You not. You're going to have to ride it out. However bad and hope you get what they thought they saw, you put out there. So anyway, I went on my rant. What you got, Bach? I know you over there investigating.
Yeah, I was still looking. I've seen projections as high as the third round for him.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, there's a pick for the Patriots.
Yeah, I give you
Arizona Cardinals.
Hey, I tell y'all what, I give y'all a chance to get some get backs. You with it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You too, Pat? You with it, Bach?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, cool. I'm gonna say he's gonna be sixth round or better for the thousand.
That's well, better than my other bet, I suppose.
I'm trying to give you.
Yeah, give me a little something.
Sixth round or better?
Yeah, he's going at least going to sixth round or
better. Oh yeah.
That gives us something at least. Get a little bit of hope.
What'd you say he was projected?
He's a day three guy, but could sneak into day two, which would be a kind of top three rounds. Oh,
so day three is what round?
A fourth or seven.
Gotcha. Hey, Terrell.
Mm-hmm.
I got you.
That's okay. I'm not going to do it.
I need to do those sit-ups anyway.
Y'all got no choice. Hey,
you're not going to make me do it. You're just going to be mad.
I will not back up off of this.
Well,
you gonna give me my money?
No.
You gonna give me my money? I'm calling Debo.
I don't care. You're just gonna be mad.
You gonna get my money?
Nah.
You gonna get my money? You got you hope you don't get to, you. Hopefully he go seventh round, first pick. Then we even.
Yeah.
But guess what? Usually I don't bet unless I'm 100% sure. Y'all must don't look at mock drafts.
Nope.
Yeah, you lose.
They don't go that far.
Oh, 93.7 the ticket. Terrell, you throwing this? You want me to do it?
Go ahead.
Bach, you throwing this? You want me to do it?
No, go ahead.
Oh, look at that. Well, you guys are in your feelings.
Yeah, have a go.
Hey, O-Street. Bach in the black shirts in their feelings. I'm sorry. I won't do it again. Jeez. Cry babies. 93.7 the ticket. We'll be right back.
Spring is here and it's time to wake up Judson. Judson Irrigation is eager and ready to get your sprinkler system up and running for the season. Judson's technicians will check for winter damage, adjust your sprinkler heads, and show you how to set your controller for effective sprinkling coverage. The Judson Irrigation team is here for you. Stay safe.
Keep summer green. Call Judson Irrigation 402-420-6277 or judsonirrigation.com.
At Parkview Animal Hospital in Lincoln, it's not just the professional care that sets them apart, but their warm staff and state-of-the-art facilities. Whether it's for a routine checkup or a comprehensive medical procedure, at Parkview, your pet isn't just another number, but a valued member of their caring family. Visit them at pahlincoln.com today and in person just south of 14th and Pine Lake Road. Parkview Animal Hospital, your pet, our passion. For happier, healthier furry friends.
Ever wish you had another light switch on the other side of the room on a dark night? How much better would you sleep at night if you had a ceiling fan in your room? The High Electric Service Department is here to make your electrical what-ifs a reality. Whether you're looking to replace some outdated light fixtures or brighten up your counters with under-cabinet lighting, High Electric can handle all types of residential electrical installations and services. Give Erica a call at 402-466-6606 or visit high-electric.com to get started.
Hi everyone, Kendall Warnock, A1 Automotive in downtown Lincoln. Spring is here, summer is fast approaching. With weddings, vacations, and weekend getaways on your mind, do not let car issues prevent you from getting where you need to be. Car problems shouldn't be something that you put up with. Let us get you back on the road in comfort and safety. We diagnose all makes and models from Porsches to Hondas, Toyotas, and Chevrolets. We fix a variety of issues with all of them with our talented techs and our experienced staff. A1 Automotive at 11th and L, downtown Lincoln, always honest answers.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox, KFXL Weather. Brought to you by Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing.
Your Lincoln forecast for today, some clouds this morning will give way to sunshine this afternoon. It'll be breezy, an afternoon high around 55. Tonight, mainly clear and breezy, an overnight low around 33. And tomorrow, we'll see mainly sunny skies and more wind, with an afternoon high around 54. Meteorologist Kyle Klecker for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Go hard, wild,
barbecue. If the week's been too hectic to even think about dinner, or your family can't handle one more night of leftovers, then it's time to let Hog Wild do the cooking. Hog Wild's family packs are one heck of a good deal for a complete barbecue meal loaded with all the smoked meats, tasty sides, buns, and sauces you need to feed your family. Order online at GoHogWild.com. Hog Wild Pit Barbecue, 3210 Cornhusker Highway in Lincoln.
But don't be late, we close at 8.
At Southeast Community College, community is our middle name. Our continuing education classes offer personal interest, traffic safety and licensing, online learning, and adult education classes across Southeast Nebraska or online in your own home. Learn pottery or floral design. Take a computer course. Learn Spanish, how to start writing a book, or Air Fryer 101. See the full schedule of continuing education classes online at southeast.edu/continuing. SCC, your path to possible.
Houses? They're expensive. And once you buy one, you're kind of stuck with it for a while. You need to make sure you get your best house for the best price. You need Ben Bleicher and his team of pros at Professional Realty Group. They'll take the time to figure out what's important for you in your dream home, and they have the expertise to find the hidden issues that could surprise you after the sale. That's professional knowledge, proactive service. We call that potential. Ben Bleicher and the team at Professional Realty Group of Berkshire Hathaway's Home Service Ambassador. Find more online at prg-ne.com.
Rashawn Jackson here for Bauer Infrastructure, a veteran-owned local company proudly serving Lincoln, Lancaster County, and the surrounding areas. Bauer provides quality work at an affordable price, and they're growing rapidly. If you want to experience a career with a fast-paced, family-friendly environment, visit BauerInfrastructure.com. They have top-of-the-line benefits, year-round work, even through the winter. Bauer, usher in the new era of infrastructure to an area near you. And as always, go Big Red!
Sandhills Global is hiring. With their fast-paced, growing culture, they have hundreds of new openings in sales, marketing, traveling support, software development, web design, and more. Full-time roles offer a 4.5-day work week, along with flexible internships in most areas. Career and internship opportunities are available at our global headquarters in Lincoln, Nebraska. Find your fit today at www.sandhills.jobs.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com. Come
on. He can't even get in the studio under the code. Oh, my God. Come on, man. Stop playing around, man. We got a show to run, man. 93.7 The Ticket. We are back in the house. The captain just coming back, break, just walking in here, just like he can do anything.
You talking to me? Was you talking to me?
Yes.
I couldn't hear you.
Oh, yeah.
What were you saying?
Come on, let's go. We got a show to run.
Oh, you was just being a cheerleader.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm here.
I was just being a VJ.
I'm here.
Okay.
What do you want? Do you want something? It's the last segment. Okay. 2 hours that went by, you ain't had nothing to say. Now you got
anything. What have you said? Anything?
I don't remember. Yeah. I don't remember. I can't remember what I said 15 minutes ago.
All right, start something up. Let's get a 5-minute topic from you.
From me?
Yeah, just
real. I've given you all the topics today.
That's a lie.
The majority of the topics came from me.
No, the topics came from really from Bach.
That's really from Bach. They didn't come from them Bach.
What?
Thinking you always turn Bach. Don't you keep Bach's name out your mouth. Golly, Bach.
Hey,
that's what you love saying, Bach. No, ain't Bach. Ain't he Bach?
Where if I see
What you think, Bach?
If I would have
seen Where was he at, Bach?
If what I see you every
look
day,
on your
I would
phone,
say,
VJ.
But, this is the guy I see every day, Bach.
If you had a phone, maybe you see me.
Hey, Moses.
Where's your phone?
Hey, God didn't need a phone.
Where's your phone?
Contact with Moses.
Where's your phone?
Huh?
Where is your phone?
The part should come in today, so I haven't called him yet.
What kind of part do you need on a phone for it to work?
Well, it's called a screen, and this is not an iPhone 10 or 11, my friend. This is like 14 max.
Let me help you real quick.
So they want $600 for it, okay?
For a screen?
Yeah.
You didn't have insurance?
My warranty ran out.
You didn't hear what I asked you.
I don't know.
No, I didn't insurance have, I didn't, don't run out. Warranties do. Insurance don't.
Well, whatever. I didn't have it on there.
Well, you got to get insurance. Who's your service provider?
Cricket? Verizon.
You're a Verizon guy?
Yeah.
And you didn't have the, you know what I mean? Cell phones I done got back free.
Every time I get a phone, I just up it. Now I probably go to the 15.
Oh, you upgraded.
Well, hopefully he can't.
How did you break it?
It dropped out my off my hip and got ran over by a cart.
A cart?
Yeah, a garbage can full of trash.
You usually listen to your headphones.
I do, but if it's in my, I got keys in my pocket. So if I'm doing some stuff looking for keys.
Why did you do that?
What?
Why did you do that?
It's called an accident, sir.
How come it's been 3 weeks for you to get your cell phone?
Because I don't want to spend $600. That's the problem.
It wants to be off the grid. Likes living off the grid.
Yeah, I like this. This is like living in the woods with just nobody out there.
Nobody
like,
to bother you.
Yeah, from what I understand, you're still making calls from somewhere.
I'm not making calls from anywhere.
Oh, you haven't made any calls since your phone been gone?
Nope.
At all?
Nope.
Tell the truth.
That's a lie! Probably three weeks ago. I made my last phone call 3 weeks ago. I received a call.
Oh, it makes it even better. How'd you receive the call?
Because my father called somebody else's phone.
That's my point. That's somebody else's phone you use.
No, I don't use it.
You do?
No, I don't.
Okay.
So, yeah, I'm off the grid.
No.
See, this is what's going to happen. This is what really supposed to happen when the year 2K posted. What they call that box with that?
Y2K. There it is again.
Yeah, Y2K. Yeah.
Hey, I'm going to take an over-under on how many times Terrell says Bach in that show.
Yeah,
I'm gonna go 15.
Mm-hmm.
You going over or under?
I'll go under.
Good job, Bach. Tell him I'm gonna go under.
Let's go back and listen.
Listen, I've heard him say your name probably about 7 times in the last 30 minutes. I'm gonna go over that.
That's good. Well, Jake, I think that's a lie. So, you know what?
Same name.
Not worried about that guy.
Same
Jake.
Name. Hey, you Jake Bob.
Hey, I could be talking
thing.
About Jake Sorensen now. Hey, you don't know which one I'm talking to.
Hey, well, you guys always want to win on the technicality. What you got up next?
Adam Carriker will be coming up. We got some Carriker Chronicles, and also just throughout the rest of the day. Pay attention because Nebraska's Terrence Knighton and Tony White took the stand today. I think they're still talking post practice.
Huh? What about you, Terrell? Y'all didn't give me y'all file, so I said
we don't care.
I put the kibosh on it.
Just keep it a captain.
All right. What are you doing after the show?
I don't know, man. I don't plan my day.
Why you got to be so difficult?
I don't plan my day. You're like, let me see what I'm going to do. I don't know.
I'm going to see Jay Gates.
Well, have fun.
I am.
Yeah.
We're going to see what Jay Gates knows.
He stays out of
way out in Pine Lake Road. You live past Pine Lake Road?
Yeah, don't come over my house.
You do live past Pine Lake Road?
Nope. Yeah.
There you do. No, I'm not going to come
Pine
over
Pine Lake
your house.
And what?
60th.
Yeah, I stay out 40. 27.
Actually, I can go up. I can go up O Street and then bank over. Huh? Would that be easier?
Well, yeah. Better have to go 14.
What's the quickest way to get to Pine Lake Road? 66 in Pine Lake Road from here.
Highway 2 to
Van Dorn.
Highway 2 to 70th.
You guys are no help. You live in Lincoln, you know. You know why? You know what? You need to be a Jay Husker because you know Jay Huskers. We Jay Huskers.
Yep.
We know how to add. We know how to get to places. We know how to go places. You guys here are a little stuck. You don't even know how to get to Pine Lake Road and 60th. Holler at your boy, dog. I'll figure it out. I'm with
the black sir.
And
Buck
Power
by
Bauer
Infrastructure
Bauer
Underground
Excavator.
See you guys tomorrow, Wednesday.
This is Lincoln's home for sports talk on the FM dial. Also online at theticketfm.com.
On the internet.
KNTK FM first. 93.7 The Ticket.
Tanner's Bar and Grill is the